What's up, Sailor Senshi? I'm Sailor Snubs. Welcome to my YouTube channel all about Sailor Moon news, merch reviews, and how-tos. I'm sure you already saw this in the thumbnail, but I have a huge box, and it's quite heavy, from my proxy in Tokyo, Japan. I've actually been sitting on this box for a very long time, so it's about time that I actually unbox this on camera so that I can actually play with all my new goodies. So what exactly is a proxy? So proxies are proxy buyers who will buy things for you if you don't have access to those items. So for example, there's a lot of exclusive items that are just available in like theaters or stores or restaurants in Japan, and I really want to get my hands on those items, so I will use a proxy buyer. Proxy buyers usually charge a percentage up front, and then they will go out and purchase those items for you. There are several different proxies that I use online, however, I usually try to focus all of my purchases through No Country for Tall Men. I specifically like to use his service because he's very transparent about his pricing, and he's also very forthcoming about what items he's going to be able to purchase for you and if there's any events that he's not able to go to. And if that's the case, I will usually try to find another proxy that will be able to go to those events for me, especially if there are items that are only available in other cities other than Tokyo, where he is based out of, then I will go to other proxies for those items too. But I always do recommend making sure that you know the original price of an item and making sure that you know how much they are charging before you choose to go with a proxy, because a lot of proxies will not tell you exactly how much they are going to charge upfront, and then you will find out after they purchase the item, or they aren't upfront about the original MSRP. So for example, if you want to do an Ichiban Kuji, which are like 680 yen, and then you ask a proxy to go and they're like, oh, each ticket is $15 USD, that's a huge difference and that's like a huge markup. So it's very important to know exactly how much you are paying, because a lot of proxies will try to scam you. So I'm gonna go ahead and get right into this box. I do have a lot of different items in here to unpack, so I won't go through in-depth reviews of any of these items, but if there is something in here that you want me to do a deep dive into, then definitely let me know down in the comments. I'm more than happy to make a singular video for any of these products. Okay, without further ado, let's go ahead and get into the box. All right, I have made a pile of items in front of me. This is a stack of items that you could have purchased through a Taiwan theater called V Show Cinemas, and they did a Sailor Moon collab. Okay, so I have four shoulder bags, and then I also have this very interesting water bottle, drink holder, drink bottle that you could get from the cinema when it was sold. So I will go through all of these. The four inner Sailor Senshi, I'm not gonna unpack all of the packaging that's inside these because I do intend to resell them. The only one I intended to get was Sailor Moon. Pretty sure I had to buy all five of these shoulder bags in order to get them shipped to the United States at the time. So I will be reselling these. Keep an eye on my Instagram, Sailor Snubs, for the sales of these four inner Sailor Senshi in case you want one of these purses. It'll be first come, first serve. More information on my Instagram. Okay, so first we have Sailor Mercury. You can see it's a transparent design. We have the three stripes along the fuku collar, and then we have the magnetic fastener to get into the purse. Each of these purses has a coordinating in color shoulder strap. So this one is designed around Sailor Mercury's colors. It sticks to itself, so it's kind of hard to fasten it. Here we have Sailor Venus. Hers has one stripe along the collar. We have the beautiful coordinating orange color for hers. This one is Sailor Mars. Sailor Mars's has a really pretty shoulder strap. I'll show you the strap. It's this pretty bright red color. And then we have Sailor Jupiter's. Jupiter also has a very, very pretty coloring to her purse. And there's her shoulder strap on the inside. The other thing I wanted to mention was the little hang tag. So this is the hang tag for the purses. You'll see on the front it says Sailor Moon Crystal. On the back we have a Toei Animation sticker. So quick question for you, do you want me to do a Toei Animation sticker walkthrough? I know there's a lot of different colors, there is some confusion around why there's different colors and how they are used, so I could definitely kind of walk through that because there is a reason behind it. Sometimes there's a reason behind it, sometimes it makes no sense, but Toei stickers, good stuff. Okay, and the last one we have of course is Sailor Moon, so this is the one I intend to keep. This one has Sailor Moon's fuku and bow and her compact on the front, And then we also have the magnetic fastener. That's what it looks like when it doesn't have any packaging inside of it. Very cute. This one kind of got squished in the packaging, so I'll have to stick something in there to kind of fix it. I do like the purse strap. It says Sailor Moon Crystal, and then it has Sailor Moon's Fuku Bow and Crescent Moons. All right, and last thing we have is this ridiculous water bottle that was also sold at these cinemas. So this water bottle has three parts to it. There's a straw right here, and then there's a top piece and a bottom piece. So here you go. You can see it. Here you go. Have some water in your water bottle. So there's this bottom piece first, which you can put a drink inside of. And then we have the top piece, which is the top of Sailor Moon's wand. And then we have the straw. And in order to put this together, you just stick this in here. Oh, it's kind of tough. It fastens into place so it won't move around on you. And then you stick your straw in there. Hopefully I can find the hole. There we go. And now you have your drink bottle. I feel like I would carry this around house parties with alcohol inside of them. I miss house parties, but wouldn't that be fun? Just carry it around with like your favorite alcohol. Put some wine in there. Delicious. That'd be fun. So for all of these items, I'm gonna put pricing down below if you can still find them. If you can't find these online anymore, I'll just put the original MSRP down below if I can find it so that you know how much this stuff costs so you can make an educated purchase if you want to purchase any of these items aftermarket. Okay, the next items I have are all from an event happening in Tokyo, which is called Small Worlds Tokyo. Have you ever been to like a model train workshop or a place where they are showing a whole bunch of minuscule models? Like some museums do this. I know there's one in San Francisco that has to do with Disneyland. I've never been there, but I really want to go. There's a bunch of different places like this. In Tokyo, they have one that is based around Tokyo or around different parts of Japan, but it also brings in different scenes from different anime. So one of those anime that they featured with little teeny tiny models set up in a teeny tiny scene from Tokyo or wherever it might have been are from Sailor Moon. And during this event, they also had a whole bunch of really cute merchandise. So all of these items are from Small Worlds Tokyo, and all of them are merchandise that you could only find there. This first item is a little bit too big to show on the top-down camera. I'll give you some close-ups though, but this is a tote bag from Small Worlds Tokyo. It was 12,000 yen. And the first thing I noticed when I took this out is the quality. It is so soft. It's like almost like a microfiber texture. It is super, super soft, which is really interesting. And I immediately was like, oh wow, that's a nice quality. So very impressed, absolutely. Looks really good. And it's also a very large tote bag. So this would be great for maybe over the summer when I take my first flight in a year and a half. There's a front pocket, which is nice. There's a zipper on the top. It comes with this smaller bag, which looks just like it. It has the same print. And this also comes with a shoulder strap. I'm assuming that you have to take this shoulder strap off and put it on the larger tote bag in order to use the little loop rings for a shoulder strap on here, because there is no second shoulder strap within this tote bag. The tote bag also has six different inner pockets, and it says Sailor Moon Small Worlds on the inside with the Small Worlds logo. There's two tags in here that say Sailor Moon Small Worlds. The smaller purse does not have any inner pockets. It's just one large pocket, but this would be very handy for taking to like Target with me just to carry my wallet and my keys. We have Hikawa Jinja on here, Azabu Juban, a whole bunch of different places that are very, very reminiscent of the anime as well as the manga. We have each of the silhouettes of the five inner Sailor Senshi, including Luna down here. We have Rei's crows up here. We also have Tokyo Tower down there. This is such a cool design. It's so pretty. Oh, I've been there. That's an actual clock that you can go see in Tokyo. There's a park in Azabu Juban, the neighborhood, and it's so pretty there. It's just beautiful. So I would definitely go there if you ever get a chance. I think that's Tuxedo Mask right there. Very small, so it's kind of hard to tell. And then we have Chibi Moon with Luna P. That is cool. This is really pretty. I'm so glad I got this, especially because the quality, it's just very pretty. Definitely worth the money. Expensive, yes, but yeah, definitely worth the money. All right, the next item we have is a traditional Japanese cotton towel, basically. This was 2,000 yen, and it features the same print, the same design. I actually really like these for laying out on the bookshelves that I put all of my collections on. I think that it's a really nice way to kind of add a finishing touch to my collection. So I put all of my collections on top of these towels and kind of use them as a part of the decor. So this will really give you an idea of what the print looks like because it's a little bit larger than the print on the tote bag. There you go. Oh, and this is the complete print from one side to the other. So starting over here, we have Sailor Mercury. There's Tokyo Tower. Yeah, that looks like Tuxedo Mask up there. We have Chibi Moon hanging out at the park. Makoto is sitting down here. Rei, of course, at Hikawa Jinja. Osapi, oh my gosh, look, that's so cool. And then we have, of course, Sailor Moon and an adorable little Luna. That was actually a real life place too, but I'm pretty sure construction changed it. So that was not around when I went to Tokyo. And then we have a water fountain here. This is so cool. I really like this print. It is kind of interesting that Usagi is in her sailor uniform with Luna, but it looks like the rest of the characters are in their school uniforms based on the length of the skirt in the silhouette that you can see. So that's kind of a difference with these. I think it would have been cool if all of them were in their school uniforms, including Usagi with these silhouettes. I think that would have made a little bit more sense. I think I have one other masking tape in here, but I'll have to find it. But this is a masking tape from Small Worlds. You can kind of see what the design is on the front right there. Oh, look at that teeny tiny little Sailor V. So cute. This is a little card holder that was 3,600 yen. On the back of the card holder, we have all the Inner Sailor Senshi signs, and then there's a transparent space for your card. On the front of this, we have a crescent moon that's metal, and then it also has the same print of all of the Inner Sailor Senshi as well as Chibiusa. This one does come with a strap so that you can wear it like a lanyard, and it also extends. Very useful. This was 1,800 yen, and it is a pen. So this is a different print for this pen, but you can also see the print on the back for the packaging. It's a little hard to see. There is a Luna and an Artemis in the background of this that float back and forth whenever you hold the pen up and down. That's what the Luna and Artemis look like. And there's also a Queen Serenity and a King Endymion. So this is like a Crystal Tokyo type of print. Very pretty. This also says Pretty Guardian Sailor Moon, and it says Small Worlds, Naoko Takeuchi. And to turn it on, you just flip it like that. I wonder what color this is. I'm just gonna mark it in here. Don't mind me. It's black. I also grabbed a couple of clear files. First, we have this Crystal Tokyo one. Both of these were 600 yen each. The Crystal Tokyo one, again, features Queen Serenity and King Endymion, as well as Crystal Tokyo behind them. And it's a really pretty ombre color. Like, this is the color I like to make my hair. So obviously I had to get it. On the back, it says Pretty Guardian Sailor Moon and Small Worlds. And the other one is the Azabu Juban print that we see. And this one features lots of purples and lots of pinks. And on the back, we have the same print as the card holder. Again, 600 yen each. Okay, so here we have a little charm. This was 3,900 yen. Kind of expensive for a little charm, but it was really cute and I wanted it. It has a little clasp, so you can put this on things. And then we have a little game station with Luna laying on the top of it. My husband just dropped off a Starbucks for me. And I love him so much. All right, we're almost done with Small Worlds Tokyo. So next we have a couple of really cute charms. This one has a very cute little Crown Arcade logo, as well as a, this is like a game coin, and it says Crown Game Center on it. And it has a little Sailor V from the game. That's so cute. The other one features Sailor Moon from the game. And then we have the Crown Game Center logo right there. Aww. And both of these were 3,500 yen each. All right, two more items from Small Worlds Tokyo. So the first item I have is a mug. The mug was 2,100 yen. I also got a teacup and saucer set, and these were 2,800 yen. And these have the Kodansha sticker on them. So first up is the mug. So this is a pink and blue and a very, very beautiful mug for all your happy things. And this features the same print of Azabu Juban. I think it's kind of cool that it's basically a map. And I'm wondering, because I have all these places tagged on my Google Maps, so I can always go back there. I'm wondering if this map is actually accurate. So I'm kind of curious. I'm gonna go look at my Google map and compare. I like the heart handle, very cute. Small worlds. The teacup and saucer set, this is definitely like for green tea. It's the perfect size, very cute. So this has Luna, Artemis, and Diana on it. Oh, I bet Diana's in the pen too. I didn't see her, it was so tiny. So that's Crystal Tokyo. And then we also have Queen Serenity, and we have King Endymion. And it says Pretty Guardian Sailor Moon. Small worlds. This is a really nice plate. Very pretty. They match up really well. Lovely. I'll have to be careful with those. Okay, so next we have a whole bunch of stationery items. I love collecting stationery. It's one of my favorite items to collect, and I use stationery all the time. So this is definitely something that I can actually put money into and actually get some value out of, as opposed to having something that sits on a shelf like a figure. Although I love figures, they're so beautiful. Okay, so first I have this really cute clear file. This is, I like to call it the ice cream collection. I don't remember the actual name. If I do, I'll put it down below. This was available at the Sailor Moon store in Harajuku. Features the inner Sailor Senshi as well as the cats. It's a really cute gingham type of print, and we have the Toei animation sticker at the bottom. This is a very cute little mirror that was available at the Sailor Moon store as well. Has the Toei animation sticker on the back, as usual. This is the Happy Birthday version. I believe this was from Happy Birthday last year. So on the front, it features Luna in this really cute art and a little birthday cake, and it's a cute heart shape. I'm gonna open this. So in order to actually get into the mirror, you just slide it like so. And then we have the back heart, which is in this like glittery color. And that's pretty cool, the fact that you can kind of fold it. So if you wanted to, you could just set this down and use it like so. Very handy. In order to lock it into place, there's a little notch right there, and you just slide it into place like so. I did find another Small Worlds Tokyo masking tape. I thought I purchased two, and I did. This one again is Crystal Tokyo. I already have this keychain from the Sailor Moon store. You saw me unbox it, I believe last year, like early last year. So now I have a second one. I will most likely just gift this to my local friend who really likes Sailor Moon as well. This Sailor Moon store keychain just features the classic Sailor Moon anime logo in Japanese. And because it is so simplistic and it's really cool because it is kind of that vintage design, I wanted to go ahead and grab one. This is a thick acrylic, just like all the other keychains that we've been seeing lately. I believe this keychain was from Lawson, which is a convenience store in Japan. This is again another acrylic keychain, and it features art from Sailor Moon Eternal, the first movie. So of course we have Super Sailor Moon and we have Super Sailor Chibi Moon, and there's a bunch of sparkles behind them. I also love that it comes with this really nice print on the back. That's a really cute postcard. And then we have another keychain, and this one features one of Sailor Moon's compacts. And then we have this cute little fake pearl and a really pretty sparkly gem in the middle. Okay, so the last items you see up here are all from the Sailor Moon store. And this was a line for, I believe it was the third anniversary of the Sailor Moon store. We have an acrylic keychain, which features Sailor Moon in this super cute store uniform. And that's actually what the Sailor Moon store bags look like. So I thought that was a really cute touch. This one is a magnet, cute, simplistic little magnet. I got several of these. I got three of the die-cut stickers because I put stickers everywhere and I love the design. I thought it was super cute. But here you can really see the details in the dress. Then lastly, we have this clear file. So the clear file again features Sailor Moon in this adorable little work uniform for the Sailor Moon store. These all look like real gemstones, which is also adorable. And the back of it features, oh, that's cool. Nice touch. We have some of the outer Sailor Senshi signs. I was kind of obsessed with this line. That's why I ended up with all of these. If you recently watched my Sailor Moon news update, Sailor Senshi News Network, you would have seen some stationery that's coming out this summer that looks exactly like these. These feature Princess Serenity in a gold and a silver design, and these are the two pens that I had mentioned came out previously, which match up with the stationery coming out this year. So these are the two pens that were available. Here's the back of them featuring the Toei animation sticker. I also just had to pick up this really pretty keychain. It is so beautiful. So I was like, I have to have this. So I'm gonna go ahead and open this so I can show you, because I feel like the logo sitting over it just does not do it justice, but it is so pretty. So this is supposed to look like a water globe. It's not really a water globe. It feels like it's made out of like acrylic or a plastic, but it is filled, so nothing's gonna float around in there. But in there we can see the castle from the Silver Millennium. And then on the back, there's not really much going on there. I love that they have a few little crystals inside of there to really add some sparkle, and there's a bunch of glitter. So this is actually a keychain, so you can put it on your purse or your keys, whatever you want, carry it around with you. Super cute. I really like the design of this because we hadn't seen something like this before, so I really wanted to get it. I'm glad I did. And then I have this new Ray Emma board. So this Emma board came out last year for 2020, and this was the 2020 board that you could get from the Sailor Moon store. These are culturally significant in Japan, so this is one of those things that you would probably never see released internationally. This is one of those things that you could only find in Japan, so I definitely wanted to grab one because I do collect these little boards. I don't write on them, I don't leave them at a shrine or anything like that. I just like to collect them and display them because I think they're really pretty. Next, I have a whole series of brand new Otedamas. At least they were brand new last year when I got this box. These are also called Tsumtsums, and they're very, very popular amongst Disney collectors, but they also came out with similar ones for the Sailor Moon fandom, and there are tons of these. I think they're on like the 11th series of these or something like that. There's a lot of them, and I do collect them. I have all of them up to these. Aren't they adorable though? I'm so in love with these little Otedamas. I think they are so cute, and they have the cutest little sushi bodies, and they look like just little poops. So this is like the school uniform line. I have Usagi in her school uniform. Then I also have Amy in her school uniform. Very pretty hair. Here is Makoto. So cute. Oh my gosh. Look at the little bow. I'm obsessed. This one is Rei. Rei looks so cute. Oh my gosh. I'm obsessed with these little guys. Then we have Minako. Oh, I'm just dying. So adorable. Oh, honey, your collar was flipped over. We gotta fix that. Okay, there we go. Much cute. We also have Naru and Umino. Oh my gosh. So adorable. Look at his glasses. Look at his freaking glasses. I'm obsessed. And his messy hair. So freaking cute. Naru looks adorable with her little green bow matching her eyes. Then we have the Outer Senshi and Chibi Moon. So here's Chibi Moon with her gigantic pigtails. She has a very cute little elementary school uniform. Michiru and Haruka match with their school uniforms. Very, very cute from Mugen Academy. Hotaru is adorable. I love her purple hair. Ugh, I'm obsessed. These squishy little sushi bodies are just, I just want to squish them all day. And then we have, of course, Setsuna, one of my faves. She's such a badass. Setsuna, you're a badass lady. Okay, so those are all of the Otedamas in their school uniforms. These are such a cute collection, and I'm so happy that I have them to add to the rest of my Otedamas, which you can see stacked up over there. The last few keychains I have are these really cute little Kewpies that are dressed as Luna, Artemis, and Diana. There's a ton of Sailor Moon Kewpies available through the Sailor Moon store if you're ever looking for these and if you're a collector of Kewpies. And then I also got this really cool magazine. It came with this Cardcaptor Sakura bonus item, which is a pen that has a whole bunch of different colors. That doesn't have to do with Sailor Moon, so I'll go ahead and put it away. This smaller clear file, which features Sailor Moon from Sailor Moon Eternal. And inside this magazine, there's not too much that has to do with Sailor Moon, but I still really like checking out Japanese magazines. I think they're so interesting. I love seeing the fashion. I like looking at how advertising happens in Japan. I think it's really fascinating. There are a few Sailor Moon items within the magazine that I did want to point out. So first off, we have this beautiful art on the front, which is definitely worth having. It is absolutely gorgeous. And then on the inside, we have an entire article about Sailor Moon, which I can't read because I can't read kanji. I can read hiragana as well as katakana, like Sailor Moon right there. But other than that, like if there's kanji, I know that says Bishoujo Senshi, but other than that, like I can't really read kanji. So a lot of times I have to use Google Translate in order to understand in between the lines. Kato, On the next page, we have an advertisement about Sailor Moon Eternal. So this has some frames that we have already seen from Sailor Moon Eternal, the movie, which releases internationally through Netflix on June 3rd. So exciting. This is really cool. This is a marriage certificate. It features Usagi and Mamoru on the front of it in front of this beautiful, beautiful art. And there's a whole section that you can fill out here if you are getting married. We also have some additional art over here, which looks like another advertisement, maybe for the color manga. And I think that's about it in this magazine. Yeah, the rest of it is just Japanese ads and fashions and articles and stuff like that. But definitely worth having just because I like seeing this kind of stuff. It's really cool. All right, the next few items are from Sunstar Stationery and Dr. Grip. So I'm going to show you these Dr. Grip pens, and then I will show you a whole bunch of Sunstar Stationery items. So these are four different Dr. Grip pens, which I really like Dr. Grip because of this kind of rubbery textured grip for these pens. It makes it very easy to hold them without having your fingers get all achy. So I do love these pens very much. So I had to get all four. So this one features Luna's butt, which is very, very cute. So we got Luna's butt right there. And it has a sparkly design to it. This is a really pretty purple colored pen. Then we have a blue one that features the Kaleida Moonscope wand at the top with a blue prism background. This one features all the little bow icons. And the last Dr. Grip pen I got features Super Sailor Moon and Super Sailor Chibi Moon from Sailor Moon Eternal. Really pretty Sunstar pens. You can tell if an item is Sunstar Stationery because it has the little Sunstar logo down at the bottom. So this is just a simple little notepad. So this one features the Kaleida Moonscope and the rest of Sailor Moon's wands. We have the moon stick right there, all of her wands. And then we also have a whole bunch of the outer Sailor Senshi items as well. And we also have Chibi Moon's items too on here. Like Luna P is right there. It comes with this background that is really, really pretty and prismy. And then the notepad itself, pretty self-explanatory. Really pretty. This is a sticky notepad, like post-it notes from Sunstar. Comes with four different prints. This is the front print. Then we have a bright pink print of Sailor Moon. There's also a print of the outer Sailor Senshi. And we have the last print, which is Chibi Moon. It's nice to have post-it notes. This is a clear file folder, which is pretty cool. So the thing that makes this different as opposed to regular clear files, which are just two-sided, this one is A4 size, but it also has several different folders within it. So here's one right here, here's another one right here, and then we fold it over, here's one here, then more folder pages. This is a pocket with a little zipper so you can zip things inside of it. And then we have another little pocket right here. So there's plenty of space for all of your things. Very useful, especially if you are going to school or something like that. This is kind of prismy too. There's a bit of a holographic look to it. It's not too much, it's very discreet, but you can kind of see that when I shift it around in the light. There you go, now you can really see it. Last but not least, I have a couple of postcard sets. So there's a full collection of postcard sets that you could get with Sunstar. This first one features Chibi Moon. We have a teeny tiny little clear file here with the outer Sailor Senshi. So this postcard set features... Okay, so first we have Sailor Chibi Moon on the first postcard. We have Sailor Uranus, Sailor Neptune, Sailor Pluto, and Sailor Saturn. Awesome. So cool to have all of those. And then we have the Sailor Moon one. This postcard set features the inner Sailor Senshi. So here's the clear file for that one, featuring the inner Sailor Senshi. And then we have Sailor Moon, Sailor Mercury, Sailor Mars, Sailor Jupiter, and Sailor Venus. Cool. Y'all, that is it. That is everything from my proxy in Tokyo from last year. This was a big box of items, and the reason behind that is because I bought a bunch of items and then they were just storing them for months and months and months for me until I got this big box shipped, which does save money on shipping. I am so happy I finally had the time to unbox this because this was such a big box of awesome items that I can actually use every single day. So I'm going to be using several of these in my studio and in my office. I cannot wait. So I'm pretty sure that I gave everything in here a pretty solid review, but if you do want to see anything in a separate video, again, let me know down in the comments below. Otherwise, thank you so much for subscribing and for liking and sharing this content with your friends. I hope you enjoyed it. And until next time, I'm Sailor Snubs. Janae.